The company with a plumber for a mascot has a nasty little habit of breaking our favorite custom firmware on our handheld devices when they put in official firmware updates. But fear not, because the folks over at 3ds.hacks.guide have got it all figured out and got us back up and running. In this video, I'm going to show you everything that it takes to get your own 2DS or 3DS system modded the right way. And we're starting now. Click the subscribe button and ring the bell to become part of the conversation. And check the video description for the links featured in the video and the latest show notes and updates. These important steps should not be overlooked before you start this jailbreak process. First, your device needs to be connected to the wireless internet so that you can access the Nintendo eShop. Second, you'll need to go ahead and sign in with your Nintendo account so that you can access the eShop. And if your device or account have been banned already, this process will not work for you. You'll need to either create a Mi in the Friends app or add an existing Mi to it, because it's a critical component of successful jailbreaking. And finally, you'll need to have an SD card or micro SD card formatted in FAT32 format. You can do this inside your Nintendo 3DS or 2DS, or use your Windows-based computer. Starting with your system powered on and your SD card or micro SD card inserted, press and hold the power button, and then tap power off to turn off the system. No matter whether you have a 3DS or 2DS, remove the SD or micro SD card from the system, remembering that the new Nintendo 3DSs have the micro SD card behind the back plate. Then power on your computer and insert the SD card. For this example, I'm using a newly formatted micro SD card that I inserted into a new Nintendo 3DS. It creates a folder called Nintendo 3DS. Double-click into that folder and you'll find a folder here that has a 32-character alphanumeric name. That's what's referred to as the ID0 character string. Click on that string and copy it. Just hang on to it in your copy queue for now. We'll be pasting it in just a moment. But for now, you'll need to remove the SD or micro SD card from your PC, put it back into your device, and then power on your 2DS or 3DS system. Once the system comes back to the 3DS or 2DS main menu, you'll need to access the Friends app. Use the D-pad to navigate up to the Smiley Face for Friends app, and then tap on it or select it with the A button to continue. On the bottom screen, use the D-pad to navigate to the right to pull up your friend card. If you'll take a look at your Mi on the top screen and look directly underneath your name, you'll see a 12-digit character. This is your friend code. You'll need to document this information and understand that this number is going to be different for you than the one you see for me on the video. For reasons unclear to me, the YouTube robots don't particularly like this website. I do have it linked, but I only have the 3ds.hacks.guide site linked. But the droids you're looking for are found right there on that page. Scroll down on this page until you see the two white boxes asking for data. You'll need to enter the two pieces of data that you've collected to this point. The first one being the ID0 number, the 32-character alphanumeric string that you pulled from your folder on your SD card. Paste that right in there. Then in the next box is the friend code information that you pulled from your 3DS or 2DS system. Just manually type in the number as you saw it displayed directly underneath your Mi character and your name. Then click on the green Go button. The site takes a few moments to start doing its magic. Then you'll be presented with a very large box, indicated in orange as shown here, that tells you that you need to enter a friend code on your 3DS or 2DS device. Make note of that code, understanding that it may be different depending upon the time that you use the website. Back on your 2DS or 3DS system, in the top right corner of the bottom display, select Register Friend. You'll be asked whether or not you want to register a local or internet friend. Select Internet in the bottom touch display. When the number pad comes up, type in the friend request number from the bot that you were presented with earlier from the website. Then tap on OK in the bottom right corner to continue. Give your system just a moment and you'll get a confirmation message that your friend has been properly registered. Transition back over to the website. You should see the word done in step 4. From here you can scroll down and you'll be able to download a file called movable.sed. Click on the green button shown here to download that file. Press the home button and close out the Friends app. From here you'll need to activate your 2DS or 3DS camera. You can just press the left shoulder and right shoulder button at the same time to activate the camera app. Use the camera function to take a picture of the QR code linked in the description below. Line up the QR code in the top screen, and in the bottom screen, touch the QR code icon to take a picture of it and link to a specific page on the Nintendo eShop. And that eShop page is for Pokemon Picross. This is a free download. You do not need a credit card or any form of payment in order to get this application downloaded to your device. Tap on the download button on the bottom touchscreen. Tap on next to get through the game's description information. Select free download in the bottom right corner. And when prompted, select download now. The game takes a few moments to download to your SD or micro SD card, and you should be all set from here. Select continue in the bottom right corner of the touchscreen, and you'll be informed that there's new software available on your device. Select OK in the bottom touchscreen to dismiss the notification. If you like opening presents as much as I do, this step's for you. Select the package with the A button, and you'll be presented with Pokemon Picross. You don't have to run the software at this point, you just need to open the present box. Go ahead and power off your 2DS or 3DS. Remove the SD or micro SD card. Then reinsert the SD or micro SD card into your PC. There are several downloads you need to get at this point. They're all linked in the description and they're all on the GitHub. The first one's called Safe B9S Installer. Scroll down to the Assets section and download the zip file. Next up is Boot 9 Strap. It's also linked in the description and on the GitHub. Again, scroll down on this page until you get to the Assets section. But take note, only download the file that says Bootstrap has the most recent version number in zip. Don't download any of the other versions as they're not going to work with this process. You'll also need the latest version of Luma 3DS, which is what empowers the custom firmware to work on your system. Again, scroll down to the Assets section. Then download the zip file with the latest version of Luma 3DS as shown here. And finally, you'll need the latest version of Universal Other App. Wait for it. It's linked in the description and hosted on the GitHub. Scroll down to the Assets section, but this time instead of grabbing a zip file, it's going to be otherapp.bin for the binary file. On the left is an open window with the download section, and on the right, the root of the micro SD card. You'll need to extract the three zip files that you previously downloaded, remembering that other app is already a binary file and doesn't need to be extracted. Just extract the three zip files and delete the zip files once you're done extracting them in order to just get the clutter out of the downloads folder and make things easier to work with. Let's slow the roll for just a minute here, because putting things in the right places on the SD or micro SD card is the key to success with the process. First, grab the otherapp.bin file and drag and drop it directly onto the root of your micro SD or SD card. Go into the Luma 3DS folder, grab both of the files that you see inside that folder, and drag and drop them directly onto the root of the SD or micro SD card. Go back one level to your downloads folder. On the root of your SD or micro SD card, you'll need to create a new folder. Name that new folder Boot 9 Strap. Once you have this new folder created and named, double-click to go right into that folder. Once you're inside the newly created folder, go back to the Downloads folder and double-click into the Boot 9 Strap folder there. Grab everything that you see inside this folder and drag and drop it over into the Boot 9 Strap folder on your SD or micro SD card. Navigate back to the root of the SD or micro SD card. Then from the Boot 9 Strap folder in the other File Explorer window, navigate back to the Downloads folder. From the list of choices, navigate up to the folder that says Safe B9S Installer and double-click into it. There's one specific file that you need out of this folder, and it's the one called safeb9sinstaller.bin. Grab that file and drag and drop it directly to the root of your SD or micro SD card. Once you're done with this, leave both of these windows open, Downloads and your SD or micro SD card. We've got some more work to do on the PC side of the house. There's a special online tool called the Pickaxe tool. It's linked in the description below. It's going to help you create a special save file that you need going forward. Scroll down on the page and click in the white box to navigate to the location where you have your movable.sed file that you created previously. In this case, it's in your downloads folder. Select that file and add it to the website. Then click on the big green build button in order to create the file that you need, and it will create it and download it automatically for you. From your Downloads folder, navigate back out of the Safe B9S Installer folder back to the Downloads folder. You'll find a new file here with a bunch of zeros in the name, the number 1 at the end of the name, and the extension SAV. It's a save file for Pokemon Picross. On your SD or micro SD card, go into the Nintendo 3DS folder, then double-click into that 32-character alphanumeric string folder. That's the ID0. The next one inside of it's called ID1. Double-click into that folder as well. You'll find a folder inside here called Title. Double-click into that folder also. Inside the Title folder, you should find one single folder with all zeros and the number 4 in it. Double-click into that folder. Even if you have other content already on your SD or microSD card, specifically go into the folder called 0017C100. Inside that folder, you'll find a folder called Data. Double-click into the Data folder. It's inside this folder where the save game files live, and there's already one present because you unwrapped the package with the game. Grab the replacement save file from your Downloads folder and drag and drop it into this folder. And when you're prompted by Windows, select Replace to replace the existing save file with the one that you created through the Pickaxe website. Alright, you're done with these windows for now. You can go ahead and close out any File Explorer windows that you have at this point. Remove your SD or microSD card from your computer, put it back into your 2DS or 3DS system, and then power on your 2DS or 3DS system. From the main menu, navigate to Pokemon Picross and launch the game for the first time. It's actually going to bypass the game launch itself and go into what's called Safe B9S menu system. In the bottom touch display, you should see a message that says All Checks Passed. If you don't see this, don't proceed. Also, when you scroll up to the top menu, you'll see a series of directional D-pad presses and a letter to press in order to activate the next step of the process. Follow those key combinations exactly as shown on your device. If you've done everything correctly up to this point, you'll boot into the Luma 3DS setup menu. Use the D-pad to move the red highlight down to Show NAND or User String in System Settings and select it with the A button to mark it. Once you have this selected, press the Start button on your device to reboot. Once your system is restarted, you'll need to power it off, remove the microSD or SD card, and put it back into your computer. We've got some more files to grab. At this point, you can delete everything that's in your Downloads folder, remembering, of course, that it's all still backed up and archived in your recycle bin. This will make the next task a lot easier to manage, as there's a lot of new content incoming. The first of these is called Anemone. It's linked for you in the description and hosted on the GitHub. This product lets you create custom themes for your 3DS or 2DS. Scroll down to the Assets section and click on anemone.cia. Checkpoint is an application that lets you manage game save files on your 2DS or 3DS system. It's hosted on the GitHub and linked in the description. Scroll down on the page to the Assets section and download the file labeled checkpoint.cia. Next up on the list is the Universal Updater app. This app works kind of like a homebrew browser in that it lets you download and install other homebrew applications. It's linked in the description and hosted on the Git. Navigate down to Assets and download universalupdater.cia. Next up is the Homebrew Launcher Wrapper. This lets you launch homebrew applications from your 2DS or 3DS. Scroll down on the page to the Assets section and click on the homebrewlauncher.cia file to download it. If you've ever wanted to have deity-like powers over your 2DS or 3DS system, God Mode 9 is just the ticket. It's linked in the description and hosted on the GitHub. It's going to empower some key settings that you need in order to permanently mod your 2DS or 3DS with custom firmware. Scroll down to Assets and download the God Mode 9 zip file package shown here. The application DSP1 is meant to allow sound to be used in homebrew applications like homebrew games. It's linked in the description, hosted on the Git. Scroll down to Applications, download DSP1.cia. The FBI application is what makes it possible to install the CIA software on your 2DS or 3DS system. Link in the description, hosted on the Git. Scroll down to the Assets section, but this time you need to download two files. You need to grab fbi.3dsx and also download the file labeled fbi.cia. CTR No Time Offset is an application that makes sure that your system clock is managed correctly now that you're running homebrew software. Link in description, hosted on the Git. Scroll down to the Assets section and download CTR No Time Offset.3dsx. On the root of your SD or microSD card, you'll need to create two new folders if they're not already there. The first one is called 3DS. Once again, from the root of your microSD card, click, select New and Folder, and this time, name your new folder CIAS. To start the transfer process, first go into the folder you just created called CIAS. In your Downloads folder, you can select every single file that has a CIA extension. They're all going to get copied into the same place. Once you have all of these files selected, you can grab them all at once and drag and drop them into the CIAS folder you created on your SD or microSD card. Back in the Downloads folder, you can delete the CIA files from your Downloads folder, remembering, of course, they are archived in your recycle bin. Next, we'll be copying over the two 3DSX files. You're still in the CIAS folder on your microSD or SD card, so you need to back out one level to the root. Find the 3DS folder that you previously created and double-click into it. Now you can grab the two 3DSX files from your Downloads folder and just drag and drop them directly into the 3DS folder on your SD or microSD card. You can delete those two 3DSX files out of your Downloads folder, remembering that they will be archived in your recycle bin. Go back a level on your SD or microSD card to the root. You should have a folder here called Luma. Double-click into the Luma folder. Inside the Luma folder, you'll need to right-click, select New and Folder, and create a new folder. Name this folder Payloads, P-A-Y-L-O-A-D-S. Once you've made it, double-click into the Payloads folder. Navigate back over to the Downloads folder, where you'll need to extract the contents of the God Mode 9 folder that you previously downloaded. Then delete the zip file to eliminate that clutter. Navigate to and double-click the folder for God Mode 9. Inside this folder, there are some key components we'll need to move over to your SD or microSD card. The first one is called the godmode9.firm file. Navigate to that file and select it, then drag and drop it over to your microSD card in the folder for Luma/payloads that you just created. While still focused on the SD or microSD card, navigate back to the root of your storage device. While you're still inside the God Mode 9 folder, inside your Downloads folder, you want to locate a subfolder that's called GM9. Grab that folder and drag it to the root of the storage of your SD or microSD card. Most fails custom firmware and application setups are due to not putting things in the right place on the microSD or SD card. Double check your work carefully. Navigate back to the Downloads folder and you can delete the God Mode 9 folder that you uncompressed, and remember, it's still in the recycle bin if you need it. Then you can close out any instances of File Explorer, and you know the drill. Remove the SD or microSD card from your computer, put it back into your 2DS or 3DS system, and then power on your device. Back at the home screen, you'll need to run a system update. To do this, navigate to the System Settings application and launch it. Once the settings main menu comes up, navigate to the Other Settings section by tapping on it. Inside Other Settings, just keep tapping the right navigation arrow on the right side of the screen until you get all the way to the end, and then select System Update from the menu choices. From there, it's just a matter of tapping on the usual parade of OKs and I accepts. At the end of this, you should get a message that says the system is up to date. Tap on the OK button to continue. You'll be taken back to your 2DS or 3DS main menu. Once you're back at the main menu, navigate to the Download Play Store and launch it by tapping or selecting it with A. When the Download Play section appears, you should see two buttons at the bottom. From this screen, press and hold the left shoulder button, down on the D-pad, and the Select button all at the same time. You'll be taken to what's called the Rosalina menu. All of Rosalina's functions take place in the bottom touchscreen, but use the D-pad and the A and B buttons for navigation. Use the D-pad to press down repeatedly to move the blue highlight down to the Miscellaneous section, then select Miscellaneous with the A button. With the arrow highlight already in place, press the A button on, switch the HB title to the current app. You should see a confirmation message of operation succeeded. Press the B button to go back, then press the B button again, and press the B button again. You'll be back at the Download Play menu. Press the Home button, then tap on Close in the bottom left corner to close out Download Play and go back to the main menu of your 2DS or 3DS. Might seem a little strange, but you literally need to go right back into the Download Play app. Tap it or select it with A. Except this time, it should take you elsewhere. It should take you to the Homebrew Launcher. In the bottom touchscreen display, tap on No CTR Time Offset. Once you have the offset set to zero, press the Start button on your device to go back to the Homebrew Launcher. Next step, time to join the feds. Tap on FBI in the bottom touchscreen. Using the D-pad and the A button, select SD from the list of choices in the bottom touchscreen. Then use the D-pad to scroll down to CIAS, the folder you created, and select it with A. You'll see all of the CIA files you copied over to it here. Your highlighter will already be on Current Directory, selected with A. Then scroll down to the list of choices to Install and Delete All CIAs, and select it with the A button to continue. And at the confirmation prompt, tap on Yes or select it with A. All of those CIA files will be installed and subsequently deleted in order to save space on your storage card. Once the installs are complete, tap on OK or select it with A to continue. Now you're done with FBI. Press the Home button, and you'll be greeted with a message that you have new gifts to unwrap. Tap on OK at the bottom of the touchscreen, then tap on the OK button to close this notification, and you'll find all of those CIA installed files waiting for you on the home screen in gift boxes. Time to rip some wrapping paper off some boxes like a kid on Christmas Day. Your 2DS or 3DS will thank you for it. Now that they're all opened up, launch DSP1. This is the thing that makes it possible for your homebrew applications to have sound. It will automatically take care of this process for you, and once it's complete, just press the B button. It will automatically delete the DSP1 application from your system and return to the home screen. At this point, power off your 2DS or 3DS system. When you power your 2DS or 3DS system back on, you'll need to hold the Start button and then power on the system. This will boot your system into the God Mode 9 menu. If you're prompted to create an essential files backup, press the A button to do so, then press the A button to continue once the backup's complete. And you also might get prompted to set the real-time clock. If you get this prompt, press the A button, set the date and time on your system, and press the A button to confirm. From the God Mode 9 main menu, press the Home button to pull up the Action menu. Use the D-pad to move the highlighter down in the bottom touchscreen to Scripts and select Scripts with the A button. From the list of choices, select GM9 Megascript with the A button. Then use the D-pad to scroll the arrow down until you get to Scripts from Playlix Guide and select it with the A button. In the next menu, select Setup Luma 3DS to CTR NAND with the A button. This step empowers your 3DS or 2DS to be able to boot custom firmware without the SD card installed. Select Yes with the A button to continue, and you'll be prompted for unlock permissions. Select Yes with the A button to continue, and you'll be prompted to enter a combination of D-pad and button presses to confirm. Enter exactly what your device shows on screen with your D-pad and appropriate buttons. You'll get a confirmation message that Luma 3DS has been copied over successfully. Press the A button to continue. Use the D-pad to move the arrow down to clean up SD card and select it with the A button. You'll be asked to confirm. Select Yes with the A button to continue. You'll get a message that everything is now squeaky clean. Press the A button to continue. Then press the B button to go back to the God Mode 9 main menu. From the main menu, select Backup Options with the A button. Then select SysNAND Backup with the A button. This process actually takes about 7 or 8 minutes or so, and you'll need about a gig and a half worth of storage space on your SD card. Press the A button to start the backup process. Once the backup's complete, it's going to show you a destination on your SD or micro SD card where the backup's been saved, and we're going to take a look at that in just a moment. For now, press the A button to continue. Then press the B button to go back one level in the menu. Use the D-pad to move the arrow down to the listing that says Dump Options, and then select it with the A button. In this submenu, use the D-pad to move the arrow down to the listing that says Dump Boot9.bin and Boot11.bin, and select it with the A button. Press the A button to confirm, and you'll get these two files backed up in the same folder that you just created your SysNAND backup on your SD or micro SD card. Then press A to continue. Press the B button to go back, and you'll be prompted to lock your SysNAND. Press the A button to lock the SysNAND on your 2DS or 3DS. Focus your attention on the top display for a moment. Use the D-pad to move that white highlight down until you get to the S SysNAND Virtual selection, and then select it with the A button. In the submenu, use the D-pad to move the highlight down to Essential EXEFS and select it with the A button. Now shift your focus to the bottom display. Use the D-pad to move the highlight arrow down to copy to O/GM9/out, that same directory we've previously been using. Then select it with the A button to continue. You'll get a confirmation message. Select Continue with the A button. Back at the God Mode 9 main menu, press the Home button on your 2DS or 3DS. From the bottom touchscreen menu, use the D-pad to highlight Power Off System and select it with the A button. Then remove your SD or microSD card from your system and put it back into your PC. Now's our chance to take advantage of that GM9 out folder. From the root of your SD or microSD card, go into the GM9 folder. You'll find the out folder listed in here. The backups you made from your 2DS or 3DS system are in this out folder. Copy this folder, and I would recommend that you paste it somewhere on your computer where you can archive this information safely. In this case, I'm just going to put it in the downloads folder because I just cleaned out the downloads folder across this process. So I'm just going to paste the out folder right here into downloads. You can archive this wherever you feel like it's best saved on your computer. And if you're like me, several months from now, if you go back to get this information, you won't remember what the folder out's about. So you might want to consider renaming that folder once it's archived on your computer. Go back to your SD or microSD card, and this time, double-click into the out folder. There are a couple of files inside this folder you can delete in order to save a tremendous amount of space, well over a gigabyte, on your storage card. And both of them have the word sysnand in the file name. In this case, it's the first two files shown here. Now that you have this data archived on your computer, you can delete these two files and save a gigantic amount of space on your storage card. Once you have these two files deleted, you can close out File Explorer, remove the microSD or SD card from your computer, put it back into your 2DS or 3DS system, and then power on your system. Now that your 2DS or 3DS system is jailbroken, you can do cool stuff with it, just like you see on this video here and linked in the pinned comment and description below.